Hey everyone! In this video, we'll show you the basics of Bezier editing, found in the contour cut feature of the Variable Data Wizard. We'll demonstrate a general overview of functions such as Bezier node styles, move lines, break, join, connect, and adding and removing nodes. To access Bezier editing in the VDW, right-click on a job in the queue and select Variable Data Wizard. Once in VDW, create a contour cut using the method previously demonstrated in the video. Easily replace text with cutlines with the Contour Cut Variable Data Wizard, available on YouTube. After the contour cutline is created, click on the work area outside the graphic to deselect all objects, then select the contour cutline. When the line is selected, you'll see that the Bezier Node Edit tool has become active. Click on this tool to start editing the contour cut. If this is the first time using this tool, you'll see a dialog telling you the contour cut path will no longer be automatically modified by the shape of the variable data that you are using, whether it's text or graphics. You have the option to tick the box to stop this dialog from popping up in the future. For the purpose of this tutorial, I will click Yes. After selecting the Bezier Node Edit tool, the smart bar above has become populated with new icons. On the left, you have icons to set the different styles of nodes. The next set of icons on the smart bar to the right include Break, Join, Connect, Add Nodes, and Delete Nodes. The last icons are Node Edit and Segment Edit, which will be covered in a second video. The icons on the left of the smart bar set the style of the node that is selected, and as a result, change the type of handles the node will have for editing. The handles control the arc and curve of a line. The four styles are Line, Cusp, Smooth, and Symmetrical. Let's take a closer look at the Bezier node styles. The first option is the line style. This is active when the line and cusp icons are clicked. You will have one handle on the node for editing the path. The next option is the cusp style. This gives you two handles which move independently of each other, both in length and angle. The third option is smooth style. This style uses two handles whose angles are linked but can have separate length, giving them separate influence over the curve. Finally, there is the symmetric style. Here you have two handles which move together in an angle as well as length, giving them equal influence on the curve of both sides of the node. You can also click and drag the line to adjust the path. The next set of icons on the smart bar to the right include Break, Join, and Connect. When you select a node, the Break icon becomes active. This will break the path at the point of the selected node. When you have a node selected, you can right-click with your mouse and a collection of icons will appear around your cursor. These include the four styles of nodes just mentioned, an icon to change the direction of the cut, an icon to set the start point, and finally the delete, break and join, and connect icons. To close the path, click and drag the mouse around the two end nodes of the open path. The connect and join icons in the smart bar are now active. Connect will merge the nodes and convert them to one node, resulting in a closed path. Join will create a line between the two nodes, creating a closed path. The next two icons in the smart bar are Delete Node and Create Node. To use the Delete Node, click on the Delete Node icon to toggle Node Deletion on. Now click on any node in the Bezier curve and it will be removed from the path. The path remains intact, but the path shape may be altered. If you have a number of nodes to remove at once, you can save time by drawing a marquee around the nodes you wish to remove. After drawing the marquee, release the mouse button and the marquee selected nodes will be deleted. When you have finished deleting nodes, click on the Delete Node icon to toggle it off. To add nodes, click on the Add Nodes icon to toggle Add Node on. Click anywhere on the Bezier path and a node will be created. To turn off the Add Node function, click on the Add Node icon again to toggle it off. Another way to add nodes without having Add Node activated is to double-click on the path and a node will appear where the mouse was on the path. Don't forget to watch our video, Advanced Tips for Editing Cutlines with the Bezier Editing Tool, which covers Node Edit and Segment Edit. Thanks for watching! If this video helped you, hit the like button, and if you have any questions, please reach out to us at any time. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos covering all of CADLINK's products.